السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدًا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدًا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألهاكم التكاثر حتى زرتم المقابر، كلا سوف تعلمون، ثم كلا سوف تعلمون، كلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين لترون الجحيم، ثم لترونها عين اليقين، ثم لتسألن يومئذ عن النعيم. وقال الله تبارك وتعالى: اعلموا أنما الحياة الدنيا لعب ولهو وزينة وتفاخر بينكم وتكاثر في الأموال والأولاد، كمثل غيث أعجب الكفار نباته ثم يهيج فتراه مصفرا ثم يكون حطاما، وفي الآخرة عذاب شديد ومغفرة من الله ورضوان، وما الحياة الدنيا إلا متاع الغرور. وقال الله تبارك وتعالى: أينما تكونوا يدرككم الموت ولو كنتم في بروج مشيدة، وإن تصبهم حسنة يقولوا هذه من عند الله، وإن تصبهم سيئة يقولوا هذه من عندك، قل كل من عند الله، فما لهؤلاء القوم لا يكادون يفقهون حديثا. وقال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام: فوالله ما الفقر أخشى عليكم، ولكني أخشى أن تبسط عليكم الدنيا كما بسطت لمن كان قبلكم، فتنافسوها كما تنافسوها فتهلككم كما أهلكتهم، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. الله سبحانه وتعالى in his book, the Quran al-Kareem, in many places he speaks about death, the undeniable reality, the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made death a prescription, something that everybody has been prescribed to taste, to go through. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala making death not the ending, but only a transition from one world to the next. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhaakum al-takathur. Have you continuously continued to rival each other and to compete in this world, fighting one another for this world? Hatta zurtumul maqabir, until you visit the graves. Kalla sawfa ta'lamun, you are surely going to know. Thumma kalla sawfa ta'lamun, nay, you are surely going to know. Kalla law ta'lamun ilma al-yaqeen, nay, if only you knew this in certainty. Latarawunna al-jaheem, you shall surely see the blazing fire before you. Thumma latarawunnaha 'ayna al-yaqeen, you will see it with certainty with your own eyes. Thumma latus'alunna yawma'idhin 'anil na'im. And on that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hold each and every one of us to account. And He will ask us subhanahu wa ta'ala about the various blessings that He gave us, the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala favored us with. And these things are only blessings if you utilize them in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you, He has favored you, He created you, He brought you to this world, He made you a Muslim, He perfected your creation, He perfected your life, He continues to bestow, He granted you parents, He granted you siblings, He granted you children, He granted you a family, He granted you knowledge, He granted you ibadah, He granted you taqwa, He granted you an opportunity to bond with Him in this world before you meet Him in the next. If you utilize all of this for He subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is a blessing. وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. All of these things are blessings that have come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if you do not use it for the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you use your eyes and your sight and your vision for that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala detests, that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He hates, you use your ears and your hearing towards that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He hates, that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He detests. Your tongue, you speak bad, you speak ill, you are a person who is foul-mouthed. This tongue now that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave, that is meant to be a blessing, for you it is not a blessing. For you it is going to bring you down to your knees. For you, لَتَرَوُنَّ الْجَحِيمِ, you are going to see the blazing fire يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Because this tongue, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith of Anas, that this tongue, it is what has led the majority of the people to the fire. To the fire. وَهَلْ يَكُبُّ النَّاسُ عَلَىٰ وُجُوهِهِمْ إِلَّا حَصَائِدُ أَلْسِنَتِهِمْ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. Is there anything that puts people into the fire of Allah face first more than the harvest of their tongues? No, it is the tongue. This tongue, it is also a reflection of what is in your heart. The way you speak, the way you interact, the way you engage with people, what you say to them. This is all showing and defining who you really are. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in the hadith in Sahih Muslim, فَوَاللَّهِ, I swear by Allah, I Muhammad, مَا الْفَقْرَ أَخْشَى عَلَيْكُمْ, I am not worried, I'm not fearful that you people are going to be people that go into poverty. You're going to be poor people and you won't find anything to eat or drink. I'm not worried about this. And I swear by Allah, I'm not worried about this. فَوَاللَّهِ, I swear by Allah, he's saying, مَا الْفَقْرَ أَخْشَى عَلَيْكُمْ. طيب يا رسول الله, what are you worried about then? If you're not worried about us Muslims who are from your ummah, not finding anything to eat or drink, what are you worried about? Walakinni, he said, rather, akhsha, I am fearful, and tubsata alaykum ad-dunya, that this world is opened up for you. Kama busitat liman kana qablakum, just like it was opened up for the people and the nations that came before you. What is going to happen? Fatanafasuha kama tanafasuha, you are going to rival one another, compete with one another. Alhaakum at-takathur, i'lamu annama al-hayatu ad-dunya la'ibun wa lahwun. To Allah, he said, wa tafakhurun baynakum wa takathurun fil amwali wal awlad, you boast amongst one another, and you are those who are competing with one another, who has more wealth, who has more children. And you don't need to say all of this, but what is in your heart, like I said, this will be defined through how you behave, through how you act. Not always what you say, but what you do in your day-to-day life. This life that Allah gave you, this entire life, Allah said in the Quran, it is meant to be for His ibadah, His obedience. Imagine a person who made this entire life dunya. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said after this, فَتُهْلِكَكُمْ كَمَا أَهْلَكَتْهُمْ. When you compete, brothers and sisters, with one another for the dunya, and the only thing you think about is dunya, the only thing you think about it is this world that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought to you only for a number of days, Allah says that it will destroy you the same way it destroyed those who came before you. This is not my world, it's not your world. I can say something, I may be wrong. You can have a view, a position, you could be also wrong. We, all of us here, as many as we are, we can all agree upon something, we can all be wrong. But what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, it is not subjective. It is, doesn't have any room for interpretation. What Allah says, it is true. This world belongs to Allah. We belong to Allah. And this next life that we are heading to, that we are not even preparing for, a lot of us are blinded towards it, it belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he advised his companions, if you wish to take this disease out of your hearts, you wish for this desire, this love that you have, this passion for you to compete with one another in this dunya, if you want it to come out of your hearts, he said, remember the destroyer of all pleasures. Remember death. And he said, alayhi salatu wasalam, that death, it is the first station of the hereafter. If you remember death frequently, the love of this world will leave your heart. How many people do you and I know from our friends and families? Or people that our friends and families know that passed away only in this year? The last year? The last 5 years? If I were to say now, whom from amongst you's father is alive? This is a khutbah. But if I were to say, raise your hands, a lot of people, they'll raise their hands. If I were to say, who from amongst you here, his grandfather is alive, we'll see many hands going down. But a few, maybe still, they will have their hands up. Tayyib, the people who have their hands up, their grandfathers are alive. Who from amongst you has his great-grandfather alive? We may see here that all of the hands go down. Where did they go? My great-grandfather has passed away. Your great-grandfathers have passed away. Our ancestors have passed away. They have never met, but they are all now in Darul Haqq. They are all together in the same place. What is going to benefit them over there? What is going to benefit us over here? What is going to benefit all of us when we go over there? It is al-amal al-saliha. It is our righteous actions. Nothing else will help you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوا قَالَ أَكَذَّبْتُمْ بِآيَاتِي وَلَمْ تُحِيطُوا بِهَا عِلْمًا أَمَّاذَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. When the people are assembled and they're brought forward before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will say, أَكَذَّبْتُمْ بِآيَاتِي. Did you reject my ayat? Did you reject my signs? Did you reject the messengers that I have sent to you and the book that I have sent down upon you? Did you reject that? أَكَذَّبْتُمْ بِآيَاتِي. The first mistake is, you are people that turned away from the religion of Islam. Then Allah, He said, وَلَمْ تُحِيطُوا بِهَا. هذا كلام الله. This is Allah's words. وَلَمْ تُحِيطُوا بِهَا عِلْمًا. Ah, of course you turned away from it because you were people that didn't even know about it. وَلَمْ تُحِيطُوا بِهَا عِلْمًا. You didn't encompass any knowledge with regards to it. You didn't study it. You didn't learn it. You didn't look at my words. You don't know what I said. So of course you can't reflect over it because you were an ignorant person. You didn't even know that which I have sent down. You didn't know that which I have done for you as my slave. You didn't know, so you can't reflect over. Then what does he say in Surah An-Naml? أَمَّاذَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. أَمَّاذَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. That is a question that you are going to hear from Allah. أَمَّاذَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. What were you doing 50, 60, 70, 80 years? You lived in Hayatul Dunya. What were you doing? Allah will say, Ya Rabbi, we studied and we learned and we had businesses and we traveled the world and we married and we had children. Allah will say to you, أَلِهَذَا خَلَقْتُكَ. Is that why I created you? All with these blessings, like I said in the beginning of the khutbah, that were you, that you used to use or you are meant to use to come closer to me. This was only a means, it was not the objective. The business and the children and all of this, if you use it in the path of Allah, it is good. If you don't, Allah, He says, they are aduwwan lakum fahdharuhum. All of these things are going to harm you. It's going to bring you pain. It is going to bring you sheer and deep regret. Fahdharuhum. Allah, He says, إِنَّمَا أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَأَوْلَادُكُمْ فِتْنَةٌ. Don't make it a fitna for you. Don't make it a trial and a test upon you. When Allah speaks about the kuffar, He says, ذَرْهُمْ. Leave them, O Muhammad. They are not listening to your preaching. They are not listening to your reminders. They are not listening to the haqq that you have come out with, that I have sent you with. ذَرْهُمْ. Leave them, O Muhammad. يَأْكُلُوا. For them to eat. وَيَتَمَتَّعُوا. And for them to enjoy. وَيُلْهِهِمُ الْأَمَلُ فَسَوْفَ يَعْلَمُونَ. We are going to give them a period, a fixed time for them to live. فَسَوْفَ يَعْلَمُونَ. They're going to find out يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. They're going to find out. فَذَرْهُمْ. Leave them. حَتَّى يُلَاقُوا يَوْمَهُمُ الَّذِي فِيهِ يُسْعَقُونَ. Allah, He says, أَيَحْسَبُونَ. Do they think, أَنَّمَا نُمِدُّهُمْ بِهِ مِنْ مَالٍ وَبَنِينَ نُسَارِعُ لَهُمْ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ بَلْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. Do they think that us giving them children and wealth, it is us giving them khayr and goodness? بَلْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. You have no idea. You have no idea. If you utilize it in good, it becomes good. If you don't utilize it in good, it cannot be good. it is only going to be something that brings you down to your knees, like I mentioned. So you remember the Akhirah by remembering the destroyer of all pleasures, Ala wa huwa al-maut. The second way that you prepare for the meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the transition from this world to the next world, the true life, the eternal life, it is to be with the Salihin, the righteous people. The righteous people who are God-fearing. How can you examine them? What is the yardstick? How do you know who is a righteous person? In reality, only Allah knows. But there are alamat, there are signs. From the signs that the ulama they mention is, this individual, for as far as you can remember, has never spoken to you about dunya. If they're not speaking to you about dunya, they have to speak. So what they are speaking about instead is the akhirah. They invite you to the akhirah. They invite you towards khair. They encourage you to do the obedience and goodness. These are the people that you remain close with. Because if you remain close with the people of the dunya, فَتَصِيرُ, you will become a person of the dunya. Ali ibn Abi Talib, the cousin of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, كُونُوا أَبْنَاءَ الْآخِرَةِ, be from the children of the hereafter. Brothers, we have people that live in this world as if they have already went to the akhirah. As if they have already went there. Their entire lives, it is revolving around this religion. And to show you how far some of us have become away from this reality, if you were to hear now, somebody comes to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He comes salatul dhuhr. Fajr is a bit early. He comes salatul dhuhr. What does he do after salatul dhuhr? And I know brothers in the same masjid that we are in. I was with one of them just yesterday for Fajr here. And he does this without mentioning who he is and without pointing to him here in this gathering. He comes salatul fajr and he stays until salatul asr and then maghrib and then isha. He stays in the masjid the entire day. He doesn't leave. Imagine someone doing this every single day of their lives. The uqul and the intellect of today, most people, not all, when they observe this individual, they will say, even if they don't say it, from their hearts, they think this. All right, where's his job? Where's his dunya? Look at the question, where's his dunya? That shows the reality, like I said earlier. What you're saying is defining who you are. You are a person of dunya, so you're observing dunya, and you are forgetting that this person is in ruku' and sujood and qira'at al-Qur'an and dhikr and du'a. He's building his paradise. He knows whatever he does here, he's going to leave it behind. It's going to be inherited. You're investing, but it's going to be inherited by others and taken away from you. Whatever you invest in the hereafter will be inherited by yourselves. He understands that. So the Muslims, they look and they say, this guy is extreme. He's only in the masjid. But we see another person, he rises early in the morning. He gets up, he goes to work. He finishes his shift, he goes to a second job. He finishes that, he goes to gym. He finishes that, he goes out with his friends. He comes home and the house is only like a hotel. He only sleeps there. Next day, same thing. Third day, same thing. The majority of the people, likewise, they look at this person and say, MashaAllah. What is MashaAllah about that? We're not saying leave the dunya and divorce it. Because even if we were to say that, brothers and sisters, we know that we can't do that. Can you do that? If any speaker, imam, khatib, sheikh, alim was to come and say, leave the dunya, it's not right to say that. But even if you were to say that, can you do that? You can't. So that's not the message of the khutbah. The message of the khutbah is qallil, reduce, decrease. Don't engage and don't invest in the way that people are doing so. If we see people that are only living for the dunya, we say, Allahu Akbar. People only living for Allah, we say, extreme. The hearts, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, they are what is blinded. Not the eyes, not what you're looking at, the hearts. فَإِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَ الْأَبْصَارِ وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَ الْقُلُوبِ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ. The hearts. If you were to say to someone now, another example, this person, this child, this son, he's hafidh al-Qur'an. He memorized the words of Allah. Awalan, firstly, a person who has memorized the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in his heart he has a copy of the Kalam al-Rahman. Mushaf, within him. What qeemah is this person sitting on? What does he have in this world that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he gave for only him to have and for the other people to only watch and observe? And they can't even understand because they don't have it. They understand only transactions and worldly things. That's what they understand. We look at this person and we don't think much of him. We hear somebody else, this person is a doctor, a businessman. This person is a multimillionaire. This person is a person who has houses and homes and he opened a lot of things and he done all of this. And what do we say? Allahu Akbar. MashaAllah. We use the dhikr of Allah to praise worldly matters. The hearts have become like that. The final thing that I like to say is, do we think really and truly that if we only live for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we take what we need from the dunya, like we said, we are balanced people, but we engage the majority of our time for our akhirah, that Allah will let us down, that Allah will not provide for us, that Allah will make you poor, Allah will make you a person who is miserable. Is that what you think of Allah? Then maybe that was your illness in the first place, your evil thoughts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maybe that's your downfall, that you don't think well of Allah in the first place, so you're scared to do the right thing. But if you don't do the right thing, you will be punished for doing the wrong thing. Like they say in this country, if you don't know, get to know. The Prophet ﷺ said something similar. عَلِمَهُ مَنْ عَلِمْ وَجَهِلَهُ مَنْ جَهِلْ. He said, the one who knows is the one who knows. And the one who doesn't know, he is the one who doesn't know. Allah gives food and drink and shelter and money and children and women to a kafir billah. A Muslim mu'min, sahibul iman. Allah will neglect him? All of this is from the traps of the shaitan and his deception. Let us live for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this world. And remember him, like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to remember him. How did he used to remember him? Our mother Aisha, she used to say, radiyallahu ta'ala anha, he used to remember Allah fi kulli ahyanihi, every single time. If he rises, he remembers Allah. If he rests, he remembers Allah. If he's standing, he remembers Allah. If he's sitting, he remembers Allah. If he's on his side, he remembers Allah. If he's traveling, he remembers Allah. If he's residing, he remembers Allah. If he's sick, he remembers Allah. If he's well and healthy, he remembers Allah. If he's alone, he remembers Allah. If he's with others, he remembers Allah. If he's going to work, he remembers Allah. One of the Salaf al-Salih, it was mentioned that one time he went to get a haircut. He's cutting his hair. And as we know, they didn't have these electrical shavers that we have in our times. They just used to use blades. So the man that was cutting his hair, he said, you're remembering Allah too much. Stop. Because if you don't, I may harm you with the blade. I'm cutting your hair, but because you're reading dhikr, I may harm you. He said, please stop. Amsik, he said, amsik lisanak. Stop your tongue. He said to him, wa anta amsik liyazzaman. And you stop time for me. If you stop time, these few minutes that you're cutting my hair, if you can stop it for me, I will stop the dhikr. But because you can't stop the time, I can't stop the dhikr. I'm sorry, I can't stop it. Hatim al-Asam, from the Salaf al-Salih, from the people of the past, he used to say, I see these people fighting and competing and rivaling one another over the dunya. فَنَظَرْتُ, he said, I saw this. He said, ثُمَّ نَظَرْتُ إِلَى الْقُرْآنِ, I looked at the Qur'an and I saw Allah saying, نَحْنُ قَسَمْنَا بَيْنَهُمْ مَعِيشَتَهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَرَفَعْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ فَوْقَ بَعْضٍ دَرَجَاتٍ لِيَتَّخِذَ بَعْضُهُمْ بَعْضًا سُخْرِيًا وَرَحْمَةُ رَبِّكَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. I saw that Allah is the one who said in the Qur'an that it is us who distribute, who provide, who give this sustenance, this rizq, this wealth, this money, this good life in the dunya to whom we want. So he said, I stopped being a person who was jealous and arrogant over himself and other people. And I said, I realized that if I want Allah to bless me, I have to fix my relationship with Allah. That is the secret. That is the message. أصلح ما بينك وبين ربك. Fix that which lies between you and Allah. Allah will fix all of your affairs for you. The dunya ones and the akhirah ones. Leave Allah. Be distant from Allah. And see everything go in the wrong direction. Wrong direction. And remember, because we are all vulnerable of death, I the other day nearly tasted death. The other day, a couple of days ago, I was in Indonesia. And when I was over there, just before Fajr, we were getting ready for Fajr. I was in a hotel, getting ready for Fajr, and the earth shook with me. I moved from the walls of the room and I landed on the floor. I landed on the floor, I fell down. Zilzal, earthquake happened. When that happened, I was by myself at the time. I've never experienced anything like that before. It came so suddenly. It came as a shock. And I by myself, who do I call out to? Who do I speak with? Even the phone is in the other side of the room. I have dropped down somewhere already. I've fallen down. No one's with me. I can't do anything. I'm in another country. This lasted for about 20 to 25 seconds. 20 to 25 seconds, an earthquake. That's a lot of time. وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدِ, after that it stopped. And there wasn't any harm caused to us, except for khawf, fear. I took the lesson that Allah did this to restore some type of iman that I must not have. I must have lost. Or maybe I didn't have it in the beginning. Another brother, a friend of mine that I met recently, after not seeing him for a long time, he said to me recently, I went into a car crash. And so he said, after the car crash, it was very serious. I met a sheikh. I said to the sheikh, Sheikh, I have a question. What's the question? The question is, we struggle with sincerity a lot, ikhlas. We know that no action in Islam is accepted without ikhlas. But we study that ikhlas, it is something difficult to obtain. Oh sheikh, help us attain ikhlas. You have alim, an alim, knowledge, and you have alimun rabbani, an alim that allows the knowledge he's sharing with you to reach your heart. He could have just said ikhlas, this is how you do it, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, 1, 2, 3. He didn't say that. He said, are you listening to yourself? He said to the young man. He said, you just said you went into a terrible car accident and you nearly died. He said, someone like you that nearly met Allah but didn't is now saying, how can I be a person who has ikhlas? You nearly died, you nearly met Allah. You nearly went to the akhirah. You were this close from going into either Jannah or Jahannam, and you're saying, how can I have ikhlas, Sheikh? He said, that answer the Sheikh gave was so profound. He said, I needed that answer so much because I didn't even realize that I nearly met Allah and I'm still asking about these sorts of matters. That's the same lesson that I took as well. This surah that is called Surah Al-Zalzalah, every single one of us here knows this surah. إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا. This surah speaks about the ultimate quake at the end of times. This surah, the last two ayat, it is a summary of our entire lives. And it's from Allah's infinite wisdom that He placed these two ayat in Surah Al-Zalzalah. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ. Anybody who does any form of good, a very small amount, an atom's weight, a grain or a seed, you will see it يوم القيامة. القدامة من المفسرين, the scholars of the past that gave the Quranic interpretation, they said, أي يَرَى ثَوَابَهُ. He will see the reward of the good. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. Same thing. Anybody who does the smallest amount of bad, شَرًّا يَرَهُ, he will see that يوم القيامة. The angels are recording, they are documenting every single thing that you write down, every single thing that you say, every single thing that you do, every place that you go, every single action that you get up to, they are recording it for you. The people who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, they make istighfar, they're worried. So they make istighfarullah, istighfarullah, istighfarullah. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, طوبى, glad tidings, لمن وجد, وفي بعض الروايات, لمن وجد في صحيفته استغفارا كثيرا. Glad tidings to the one who finds يوم القيامة on his scroll a lot of istighfar. Because even if you make mistakes, this istighfar will eliminate everything. Always remember Allah. Dhikr, all of the time. And we said, all of the time as well, remember death. We said, all of the time as well, be, and this one is very important, be in the presence of people that are righteous, salihin. And we said, the yardstick for that is, see what they're calling to, see what they're inviting to. And if you do this, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, it will ward away the shaitan, and it will ward away the soul of ours that's only inclined to doing worldly things. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will give us the best in the dunya and the best in the akhirah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد, إن الله أمركم بأمر قد بدأ فيه بنفسه وثنى فيه بملائكته المسبحة بقدسه وثلث بكم أيها المؤمنون من جنه وإنسه, فقال عز من قائل, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي, يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. وقد قال صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, من صلى علي صلاة واحدة صلى الله عليه بها عشرة. اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. وارض اللهم عن آل بيت نبينا الطيبين الطاهرين, وعن أزواجه الطاهرات أمهات المؤمنين, وعن ساداتنا الحنفاء والأئمة الخلفاء ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي, وعن سائر أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجمعين, وعن التابعين وتابع التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم عنا معهم بما منك وفضلك ورحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، أذل الشرك والمشركين، دمر أعداءك أعداء الدين يا رب العالمين. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا، اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا، اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا، ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات، الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العظيم الكريم يذكركم، واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدًا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح. قامت الصلاة، قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
استووا، اعتدلوا، تقاربوا، تراصوا، أتموا الصفوف، سدوا الخلل. Please silence your mobile phones, reading your lines, fill in the gaps, and complete all the rows. Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. الرحمن الرحيم ملك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. سيقول السفهاء من الناس ما وليهم عن قبلتهم التي كانوا عليها قل لله المشرق والمغرب يهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم وكذلك جعلناكم أمة وسطا لتكونوا شهداء على الناس ويكون الرسول عليكم شهيدا وما جعلنا القبلة التي كنت عليها إلا لنعلم من يتبع الرسول ممن ينقلب على عقبيه وإن كانت لكبيرة إلا على الذين هدى الله وما كان الله ليضيع إيمانكم إن الله بالناس لرؤوف رحيم قد نري تقلب وجهك في السماء فلنولينك قبلة ترضيها فولِّ وجهك شطر المسجد الحرام وحيثما كنتم فولوا وجوهكم شطره وإن الذين أوتوا الكتاب ليعلمون أنه الحق من ربهم وما الله بغافل عما تعملون ولئن أتيت الذين أوتوا الكتاب بكل آية ما تبعوا قبلتك وما أنت بتابع قبلتهم وما بعضهم بتابع قبلة بعض ولئن اتبعت أهواءهم من بعد ما جاءك من العلم إنك إذا لمن الظالمين الذين آتيناهم الكتاب يعرفونه كما يعرفون أبناءهم وإن فريقا منهم ليكتمون الحق وهم يعلمون الحق من ربك فلا تكونن من الممترين الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله
لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله
الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم ملك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين الحق من ربك فلا تكونن من الممترين ولكل وجهة هو موليها فاستبقوا الخيرات أينما تكونوا يأتي بكم الله جميعا إن الله على كل شيء قدير ومن حيث خرجت فولِّ وجهك شطر المسجد الحرام وإنه للحق من ربك وما الله بغافل عما تعملون ومن حيث خرجت فولِّ وجهك شطر المسجد الحرام وحيثما كنتم فولوا وجوهكم شطره لئلا يكون للناس عليكم حجة إلا الذين ظلموا منهم فلا تخشوهم واخشوني ولأتم نعمتي عليكم ولعلكم تهتدون كما أرسلنا فيكم رسولا منكم يتلو عليكم آياتنا ويزكيكم
ويزكيكم ويعلمكم الكتاب والحكمة ويعلمكم ما لم تكونوا تعلمون فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروني ولا تكفرون يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة إن الله مع الصابرين الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر
لا إله
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله